Well, welcome back to the Corona Guitar Build. And we are at monumental stage. We are about to start the finishing process. And I gotta admit, it's not my strong suit. But I've received some advice from some friends, and I have a game plan. And let me tell you what that is. So, to get to the stage that I'm at now, I've gone through my sandpaper, started at 80 for some spots, 100 grit for other spots, then moved to 120, 220, then final coat 320. And it is pretty, it's pretty good. I'm just tired of sanding, and it's kind of, I guess one of my faults is I just kind of say, all right, it's good enough, because I get bored of sanding and I want to move on. So, but it's pretty good. I've gotten a lot of the scratches out. There's a couple I just couldn't do, and I'm gonna assess it after I do my what they call a wash coat, and that's basically what I'm about to do now is a wash coat of shellac. And essentially, after it's completely tack ragged, as you can see I've done, I'm just gonna take a wadded up piece of old t-shirt and apply maybe three, maybe five thin coats of shellac, overlapping seams, so on and so forth, and let it dry for a couple hours in between each coat. And then after I've done that and maybe found some blemishes, I want to re-sand and touch up with some shellac again. Then I will move to a lacquer, 15 coats of lacquer at that point. So, it's a lengthy process. One thing I do want to do, though, I forgot, is I want to tape off the fretboard and the nut and the bridge, because I do not want to get shellac on that. So let's take it back down and do that real quick. Thank you. this is the shellac I'm using, bullseye shellac. I know a lot of people, you read a lot of people say never to use the canned shellac, always to get the flakes and the denatured alcohol and mix it up in batches as you need it. I get it if you are doing a lot of finishing all the time. That might be cost effective, but you know the bullseye shellac says it has a 3-year shelf life, and I tend to believe that. I've never had a problem with it, and you know, just check the date code on it, and I think it's fine. So that's what I'm using here. I'm just going to mix it up real well. Now, the better you mix it up, the better it goes off. And then I'm going to work right out of the can, too. Smells like whiskey. Mahogany and even the walnut has such a high amount of resin. You can see it coming off on the rag. So when I do the top is cedar. I don't want to mix that resin in, so I'm going to either get a clean rag or a clean part of the rag.
Dry for a couple hours and we'll come back.
Alright, so that's been about 2 hours, and I'm just gonna do a light scuff sanding. And I'm just, the only pressure I'm applying is just really like the weight of my hand.
Yeah, this helps level it a little bit. Also helps for adhesion of the second coat. Then the light tack rag here, just to get the loose dust off. And my scuff sanding, I'm using 320 grit. Final coat. Light scuff sanding. Color tone, and
you know, we're going to shoot this today. I'm going to do about 14 to 20 coats, something like that, of this. And the process is basically going to be 4 to 6 coats, a couple hours between each coat. Let it dry overnight. Then the next day, do a level sanding, basically 220 grit paper with mineral spirits. Give it a full sanding. Let that off gas. And the following day, repeat that process, another 4 to 6 coats. You know, let that dry overnight. Following day, mineral spirits at 220. So now we're about 8 to 12 coats. And once that off gases for a day, we will do another 4 to 6 coats, getting us up to 12 to, you know, 15, maybe do a few more, and let that dry for 14 days. And then once that's dry, we'll level sand it with 800,000 grit. Hopefully get a polish it, hopefully get a mirror finish on it. So before we spray it though, I'm gonna tack it, make sure there's nothing I miss with the scuff sand, no areas that aren't scuff sanded, and spray this on. So I should mention, this is the first time shooting lacquer for me. I got this game plan from my friend Richie Murmur Guitars. I'll put a link in the description. My first guitar, I did a white bond poly, and came out all right. If you're gonna do a white bond poly, I suggest doing just a satin finish. Anything more just doesn't, it's too uneven. And you really gotta do a lot of sanding and polishing. So I'm hoping that this method has better results. Coat two. coat three. Alright, so it's the next day. I'm gonna take a little mineral spirits. Put that in a container. And I have 320 grit wet dry paper. And I'm gonna wet dry sand. Wet sand this whole thing down. And get it nice and smooth. Thank you. hangs back up. Tacked again. We're gonna try and get another 6 coats of lacquer on this and see how it goes. I don't know if I mentioned before, but respirator is a must. Good ventilation is a must. Stuff is very flammable. Toxic. This is coat number 8. Code number 9. Coat number 10. Gonna put it on a little thicker this time. Try and get more of a gloss. Hopefully no runs.
All right, guys, so it's been a day, full day since I sprayed the 10th coat of lacquer, and I'm gonna use mineral spirits again and the 320 grit paper and wet sand it smooth. And after I do that, I'm gonna let it degas for about at least 2 days, and then I'm gonna shoot another, I don't know, maybe another 6 to 8 coats of lacquer. Got another shipment in lacquer, and this is gonna be the 11th coat. I did a light sanding on it with 320 grit, wet sanded, very light, and wiped it down. Let's see what happens. Keep putting it on, and like I said, I'm gonna put it on real thick. So. Hopefully, we'll start really building up the lacquer. I feel like these first 10 coats, excluding the 10th, have been just too thin, and it's just not building up quick enough for me. You know, the Stumac site where I got this said I should go through around 6 cans of lacquer for this size guitar. Already gone through 2. So let's see. Oh, and I bought 4 more cans, so let's see what happens. My plan is to use all 4 cans. Coat number 12.
code number 13.
Going on extra thick. Alright, so it's the next day. Yesterday I put 5 coats on and it dried overnight, and I would have done more, but I ran out of daylight, so to speak. So I'm up to 15 coats. It's quite a nice gloss, and I want to get 18 coats on here before I decide whether I'm going to end my lacquering and start my polishing or keep going. I have about another can and a quarter left, so I'm going to put 3 more on.
All right, guys, so it's about, I don't know, maybe about 4 days later, and the 18th coat is definitely dry, fully dry to the touch, although it's about 14 days to fully cure, so I really can't wet sand the orange peel out of this, nor can I buff this to a mirror finish until 14 days has passed, because that will just you run the risk of just burning right through your finish if it's not fully cured. So I think overall though, I like it. You know, the spray lacquer I used, the first two cans that I bought from Stumac, they seemed to be, I don't know if it was a bad batch or temperature or humidity just wasn't right, because it went on very, almost like a chalky residue, or it was very rough, and it was a high gloss lacquer, and there was no shine to it whatsoever. So I bought four more cans after those two, and it was a completely different feel to it and outcome. Obviously it was there's still a little bit of roughness to it, but the shine you can see is there. Like the neck, there's no roughness at all. It's very smooth. You know, I think a lot of it has to do with just how thick you put it on. If you stay in one place or you move a lot. I'm still sort of getting used to spraying on lacquer, the nitrocellulose lacquer. So this was my first attempt at it. But I think really at this point, the video, I'll end the video, and in 2 weeks time from now, I will show you my process for wet sanding it and buffing it, polishing it, using a buffing machine that I'll go into a little more detail as well. Hope that helps you guys out, and that outlines the way I'm doing this finish, and I hope it helps you with your finish. But I think that'll be it for now. I appreciate everybody watching and subscribing, and like, comment, and subscribe if you're new, or if you're not new, you can just like and comment. But I appreciate any feedback you guys could give, and tune into the next video. And once we get it buffed and polished, we'll finish fretting it, put some strings on it, the tuners, and play a couple notes. But until then, see y'all next time.